Hey everybody, and welcome back to iDrive Daily. On today's episode, we are going to open the new catch can from Elite Engineering. Let's get started. Alright everybody, so we're going to open this new catch can from Elite Engineering, and then we're going to talk a little bit about why I purchased a catch can. There is debate around it. But I know most of you are here just to see what comes in the box, so let's start right off with that. Alright, so we have the actual can here. And this is a pretty common version catch can for C5 Corvettes. I know a lot of people purchase the Elite Engineering. And that's what the inside looks like. So of course there's a mounting bracket. Included hardware and elbows such that, you know, the pipes can hook up, the hoses can hook up. Now, one thing I did spring for, I sprung for the wrapped hoses. It does come with rubber hoses standard. I paid a little extra to have these these stainless steel wrapped hoses. Just because I like the look, that's the only reason I went ahead with these. So yeah, pretty straightforward what comes in the kit. There's not too much exciting, not too much unexpected. This is exactly what you're purchasing if you're buying the Elite Engineering kit. All right, so let's talk quickly a little bit about cost. This Elite Engineering can cost me $230, just a little bit north of that. I don't remember how much exactly these hoses add, but I think you're looking at around $200 if you go with just the standard rubber hoses. That's basically what you're getting all of this for, and it's a pretty easy installation. So I think it's a pretty good price. So there's plenty of other options out there, but Elite Engineering seems to have a pretty good reputation, and a lot of people use them. I know there's a pewter Corvette in my area that has an Elite Engineering. I know Dave at Yellow Vet has a Elite Engineering catch can. So I really went with this because it seems like it's a pretty common catch can when it comes to C5 Corvettes. I know that's actually kind of opposite of usually how I build my Corvette. I try to go with things that are uncommon, but for this functionality, it just seemed like it had a really good reputation, and I was almost dumb to pass it up. All right, so let's talk a little bit about whether or not you actually need a catch can on a C5 Corvette. So down in the description, there is a link to some really good information explaining exactly how the systems work. And it compares it to like 1920s, 1930s cars, cars from the 40s, 50s, 60s, a little bit of how this, how the pressure changed in the manifold and how they routed it. It's really actually an interesting read. I would totally be lying if I told you I understood every bit of it, but I got enough of it to understand that this system, a catch can, is actually a pretty good idea. So I originally bought this because I wanted it, not because I necessarily needed it. However, if you take off the intake manifold and you find oil inside, that's basically the PCV valve at high RPMs is getting blow by, and it's kind of sending oil back in there. If you're getting oil in there, there's a pretty good chance that you're going to want to invest in a catch can. When I took off the manifold in a couple episodes ago, I found a ton of oil in there. As a matter of fact, if I can find an image of what underneath looked like, you could tell exactly where the oil was going into the engine, and it actually wasn't going into each port equally. There was one port that was extremely oily. There was a lot of buildup in it. So I had bought this before that, like I said, because I wanted it, but the fact that I bought it and then pulled off my intake and saw that in there, I was actually glad I bought it. So I am not regretting this purchase. I know $230 is expensive. People generally don't want to spend stuff that doesn't make horsepower or torque, but for the longevity of the car, I think that this was a great investment, and I'm gonna get a lot less oil blowing back in there. So on the next episode, we're gonna install this. Like I said, it's a really easy installation, and I'm pretty excited for that. I have a few other parts, I think I have one other part sitting around, and that's an exhaust kit. So hopefully we'll be doing that in a short little while. So with that being said, let me know down in the comments if you guys also run a catch can, if you think it's unnecessary. Like I said, it's a debate out there. Everything's debatable. Some people say, you know, on a stock LS1 or a stock LS6, LS7, you really don't need it. But taking off my manifold, like I said, I saw a lot of oil in there, and it makes me really happy that I purchased this kit. So let me know down in the comments if you guys are running one or not, and I will see you on the next episode.